Completed that contract. Someday maybe you and I are running this place. I mean, it kind of feels like you are working for me already.
Thank you. adding to the list.
Every day, the dinosaurs are testing new strategies to overcome our methods of containing them. If we are to survive, and yes, that's what we're dealing with, then we need to stay one step ahead of them. That's where a contract like this latest one comes into play. This is our step. You know, I told John that I'd return to his elaborate prehistoric ant farm under one condition, that nobody else dies because of something that shouldn't be alive. And that still holds true.
No diseased dinosaurs detected.
Stand by for helicopter arrival.
Ooh.
Resupply request acknowledged.
That contract is complete. You found a way.
Acknowledging request for feeder resupply. Understood.
There was a time when the only person I trusted on this earth was Dr. Sattler. But now, thanks to you, I'm considering expanding that circle.
No problem. Setting additional task. Request acknowledged. Acknowledged.
Thank you.
crew to pick up the asset. Asset required inspection. Assets in the air. Asset to be collected. Confirming asset delivery.
that we are attempting to simulate the dinosaur's environment, but I would advise strongly against letting them fight. I have firsthand knowledge of what can happen to anyone who gets in their way.
Picking up asset.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are pleased to welcome a Ceratosaurus to the park.
Transportation complete.
I'd say you're unbelievable, but everything around the islands kind of falls under that category.
Mr. Hammond says we need more attractions in the park.
Living dinosaurs aren't enough.
Of course, they attract attention, Dr. Grant, but once people see what they can't believe they're seeing, they've seen it.
I am honestly trying to follow you.
People always want more.
The dinosaurs should be enough.
Maybe we can give them a new one.
Let's go for the compies. They're relatively harmless, right?
Really, Alan? Nothing here is harmless.
Now, if we could only make Mr. Hammond believe that. There's a new contract available. You should give it a look. You would think that one living specimen of an extinct animal should be more than enough for all of us. But it's not enough, and we need more.
Actively incubating even more carnivores? Are we, Dr. Sattler?
I need the genome first. At least enough to fill in the gaps of a compy.
Hammond knew what he was doing when he reached out to you.
What does that mean?
With all due respect, Dr. Sattler, you're a zealot. Like he is. No offense.
I didn't realize believing in something was a weakness. If my belief ensures the health and safety of life on this island, be it dinosaur, human, or even a tiny little plant, then that's all that matters to me.
Say, have you ever heard of summit fever, Dr. Sadler? In mountaineering, it's what gets climbers killed. The desire, the compulsion, if you will, to reach the top becomes more important than anything else, more important than survival, even. That's John Hammond.
And that's also me? That's what you mean?
I'm only offering perspective.
When you're trying for something, you want to achieve it, especially something you've dreamt about your entire life.
It's not the goal that concerns me, Dr. Sadler. It's the cost.
Confirmed. Collecting asset. Asset has been collected. En route to collect the asset. Acknowledged. Asset collection has proceeded.
Let's get some into an enclosure and make sure they have access to food and water.
Thank you. Heading to collect.
Jurassic Park is about more than preserving nature on a couple of islands. It's about recreating an entire way of life. Maintaining that takes effort and success like yours.
Collecting asset.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Because our hands aren't full enough with walking and crawling dinosaurs, now you want dinosaurs that fly?
They're reptiles, actually. And just imagine what it would be like to witness them taking flight. Within a secured enclosure, of course. Now, I just need to find Cabot. He seems to have flown the coop.
Which these dinosaurs, reptiles, can never do. Like, ever. And you know that for a fact. Right, John?
A secured aviary, Dr. Malcolm. What goes in, stays in.
But, John, what exactly goes in? Dr. Grant, the aviary research is complete.
And you believe in the findings?
As much as I believe in anything here, which is to say, no. But the engineers are confident in the design. I mean, they were before, too, so, you know, we've got that to fall back on.
Okay, we'll get this aviary built, powered, and connected to the rest of the park. Then we'll be able to have one of Ellie's favorites available for study and on display.
We're doing it, Alan. We're all doing it.
Doing what?
Proving Hammond right.
I can't wait to see them fly.
I hope our guests share your enthusiasm, my dear Dr. Sattler.
Pteranodons. Alan, pteranodons. Can you believe it?
How many times has that question been asked on this island?
It's not how many times it's been asked, Dr. Grant, but how many times it's been answered. Today, Jurassic Park takes flight.
Thank you.